Red Twilight, A Dawning of Power, Chapter 10. Lest he locks the blades down on his black tails, the door rattles. Someone is out there. It sounds too small to be a zombie. The other child. Lest he thinks. He looks to L. L looks back. Another battle starting in his mind as he thinks. Is the value of one life worth seven? Of course. Lasty nods his head to the door. L reaches for his jackal. I'm going to open the door. Someone is out there still. We are going to rescue them. Anyone that would like to help, it would be appreciated. L explains as he and Lashley begin to unbarricade the door. Jacob looks stern. He nods as he grips the machete and slices it into the crossbar of his shotgun. Snake looks to Jacob for approval, then nods also. Larry stands in protest. Are you all nuts? What if it's another monster? L looks to him momentarily. What if it's a child? Lousy brings up a huge foot and kicks the door out. The waiting monsters scatter in shock as the party pour onto stage. Snake looks to L as he raises his weapon. This already failed once. He says he shoots two zombies' eyes out, dropping them in a much more controlled fashion than before. The mission is search and rescue, not seek and destroy. We don't need to kill our enemies, only retrieve the target. L spots the wolfen. Having just leapt to its feet, it shoots a single shot that rips through a zombie before hitting the wolfen clean in the kidney. The monster howls in pain as it starts to limp away. Last, he lets out a battle cry as he springs the blades on his guns. He skillfully dances around the field, slashing at his enemies and smashing through flesh and bone without difficulty, dismembering his foes as they fell. A zombie runs at Jacob, who holds out his cross-shaped weapon as a shield. The symbol seems to frighten the undead, and it freezes in its tracks. Jacob fires his gun. The force impact flings the zombie into the air. As it falls, it burns. Jacob looks for a moment at his holy shotgun. Last, he notices the phenomenon. Without understanding, he changes his tactics to decapitation, severing heads with every opportunity as monsters jump and grip at most everyone. The group is better prepared this time, and the party forces the undead into a retreat. Another body jumps at Larry. He grabs it. Snake, is this you? A short distance away, Snake shoots an enemy twice. Nope, he pauses to say. Well, fuck off then, Larry tells the thing in front of him as he places his gun against his chin and shoots three times. Beaten back, the beasts scatter to the wind. Hey, Pistol yells from above. Which one of you boys is daddy? He pounds the handrail to get the party's attention. Jacob looks up. That is me. Great, Pistol yells down. Big stuff. Give me a hand. He calls to Lashti. The tall man smiles and nods, recognizing the child with pistol. Ashley, I'm going to wrap my whip around your hands and lower you down. That man is a friend of mine. He's going to catch you, then I'll jump. Ashley smiles and nods her head. Pistol slowly lowers Ashley to the ground, as far as he can until he runs out of slack. He drops her into Lashti's waiting arms. Suddenly, with no sign of warning, the swarm of flesh eaters return, double the number. These ones are twice as aggressive as the ones before. Pistol's eyes go wide as he mumbles, "Well, shit." He dashes off to the other end of the catwalk, searching for a way down. A beast leaps at L, but the bald man slings it off. Then it crashes into Lashti's slashing blades. Larry and Snake stand side by side, flashing their own blade. "Bro," Snake instructs, and they begin moving to clear a route with merciless aim and skill. Jacob holds out his shotgun cross and begins to sidestep towards Lasserty and Ashley, the beast thin, letting him pass. One brazen monster charges him. Ignoring the pain that staring upon the cross offers, Jacob pulls back his weapon, draws the knife, and strikes a deadly blow across the monster's torso. The cross is broken. Half a dozen monsters rush him simultaneously. Jacob shouts a battle cry as he lets a raining halo of slugs fill the air, then starts furiously slashing his way through the hellspawn. Jacob is weakened. Suddenly he stops in mid-swing and drops his knife. He moans as he grabs his chest. Time seems to stop as both the beast and man look to see what has happened. The last of strength nearly gone, Jacob closes his eyes and falls to his knees. "Lance!" Snake yells. He turns around and recommences with combat by unloading the rest of his clip into the beast facing Jacob. L glances over as he swings around a monster to break it in half. "On your feet, old man," he whispers. "It's too early to die." Lashley howls as he cuts his way to Jacob. "Charlie," Ashley calls, "help us." Ashley runs to her father, shoving several monsters out of her way. Trash runs to stop her. "Stop," Trash orders. Ash begins to cry as her father falls forward onto one hand. Spooky Shoulder rushes two zombies away as he shelters the two girls. Pistol watches the chaos below. "Fuck," he thinks aloud, finding no easy route to the ground. "Tally-ho," he yells, gallantly leaping the catwalk to Jacob's aid, playing the role of Ashley's knight. He lands on two monsters, seemingly crushing them. L points to Jacob and commands, "Pick him up." On cue, Lashti tosses both Ashley and Jacob onto his back. "Fall back, double time," he orders, waving his unit onwards to safety. The group now nine strong, fart their way past the waves of the dead. Pistol collects his whip and takes up the rear as he heads to the sanctuary in the storage room. What a terrible night to have a curse, Pistol thinks as they run. The battles have already been trying and plentiful, and the night has hardly begun.